Guys, welcome back to Timeless Black Excellence. This is your host, Abdias Dalizme. 1873 in Ohio, Charles Patterson became the first African-American owner of an automobile manufacturer. Patterson went into partnership with J.P. Lowe, and in 1893, Patterson bought out J.P. Lowe's share of the business and reorganized it as C.R. Patterson Sons Company. The company built 28 types of horse-drawn vehicles and employed approximately 10 to 15 individuals. And in 1910, he left the carriage business to his son, Frederick, who turned the company from a carriage business into an automobile manufacturer. He was a college-educated man and was the first black athlete to play for Ohio State University. He was also an early member and vice president of the National Negro Business League, founded by Booker T. Washington. The first Patterson-Greenfield car debuted in 1915. With a four-cylinder engine, the car was comparable to the Ford Model T. The Patterson-Greenfield car may have in fact been more sophisticated than the Ford's car. The company soon switched to production of trucks, buses, and other utility vehicles. Around 1920, the company reorganized as the Greenfield Bus Body Company. We were manufacturing cars? I'm like, why didn't we know that? And why aren't we still manufacturing cars? We need to get on this. 1932, Richard B. Spanks received a patent for an automatic gear shift for cars. He also invented automobile directional signals and is credited with creating the automatic safety brake in 1962. Also, did I forget to mention that he invented the beer keg tap, which Milwaukee Brewing Company bought from him and made him a very rich man? Think about that the next time you go to your next kegger. On behalf of Mr. Spikes, you're welcome. In 1977, Dr. Patricia Bath and three other colleagues founded the American Institute for the Prevention of Blindness. She was also the first woman ophthalmologist to be appointed to the faculty of the UCLA School of Medicine, Jules Stein Eye Institute. In 1981, she discovered and invented a new technique for cataract surgery known as laser phaco. Harnessing laser technology, the device created a less painful and more precise treatment of cataracts. The laser phaco probe uses a system of lasers, suction, and irrigation to remove the affected lens and replace it with an artificial lens that won't deteriorate over time. This combination of technology provides a non-invasive as well as most permanent solution for cataracts. You can thank a black woman for laser eye surgery? Incredible. Although Daniel H. Williams didn't invent the open heart surgery procedure, he was the first surgeon to do it successfully. He also opened Provident Hospital, the first hospital with an interracial staff, in 1893, and in 1894, he was appointed chief of surgery of Freedmen's Hospital in Washington, D.C. Lonnie Johnson began working as an engineer for NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory in 1979. During his time at NASA, Johnson worked on the Galileo mission to Jupiter, the Mars Observer Project, and the Cassini mission to Saturn. He earned multiple awards from NASA for his spacecraft control systems. But Johnson is possibly best known for his invention of the Super Soaker water gun. The inspiration hit him while he was working on an eco-friendly heat pump. I quote, "I accidentally shot a stream of water across a bathroom where I was doing the experiment and thought to myself, this would make a great gun," Johnson said. The Super Soaker's success allowed him to work for himself and fund his own research in green technology. Johnson also holds over more than 100 patents. The inventor of the Super Soaker worked for NASA? Interesting. Mark E. Dean is an American inventor and computer engineer. He was part of the team that developed the ISA bus, the computer monitor with color, and he led a design team for the making of the 1 gigahertz computer processor chip. He holds 3 of 9 PC patents for being the co-creator of the IBM personal computer that was released back in 1981. Dr. Charles Drew invented the blood bank in 1940. He also invented blood plasma bags in 1945. He became one of the most important scientists of the 20th century. His developments in the use of preservation of blood plasma during World War II not only saved thousands of lives, but innovated the nation's blood banking process and standardized procedures for long-term blood preservation and storage techniques adopted by the American Red Cross. Otis Boykin invented a control unit for the pacemaker, which is a device implanted in the body helps the heart beat normally. In 1914, Garrett Morgan invented a breathing device that became the prototype and predecessor for the gas mask used during World War I, protecting soldiers from toxic gas used in warfare. The invention earned him the first prize at the Second International Exposition of Safety and Sanitation in New York City. Garrett Morgan also patented his version of the traffic signal. It was the signal that eventually attracted the attention of General Electric, which bought the rights from Morgan for $40,000 back in 1923. Granville T. Woods, better known as Black Edison, registered nearly 60 patents in his lifetime, including a telephone transmitter, the multiplex telegraph, and a grooved metal wheel that allows streetcars to collect electronic power from overhead wires, later known as trolley cars. Wood's most important invention was the multiplex telegraph or block system in 1887. Woods actually defeated Thomas Edison's lawsuit that challenged his patent and turned down Edison's offer to make him a partner. For those who didn't catch that, Woods was the actual inventor of the telegraph. Thomas Edison tried to sue him, and then Edison lost the lawsuit. In 1960, James West teamed up with fellow scientists Gerard M. Slezer and developed an inexpensive, highly sensitive, compact microphone. In 1962, they finished development on the product, which relied on their invention for electric transducers. By 1968, the electronic microphone was in mass production. Wes and Sessler's invention became the industry's standard, and today 90% of all contemporary microphones, including the ones found in telephones, tape recorders, camcorders, baby monitors, and hearing aids, use their technology. On November 11, 1969, Dr. George Crothers received a patent for his invention, the image converter, for detecting electromagnetic radiation, especially in short wavelengths. He also developed the first moon-based space observatory, an ultraviolet camera that was carried to the moon by Apollo 16 astronauts in 1972. The camera used in the Apollo 16 mission produced about 200 photos revealing new features of Earth's far outer atmosphere, as well as deep space objects from the perspectives of the lunar surface. Thanks, guys, for tuning in to this segment of Timeless Black Excellence. Just want to thank everybody that has hit that like button. Also, everybody that has subscribed to the page. I do appreciate every single one of you. Like, subscribe, and share. Please also leave comments and give some insight on what you'd like to see in the future, or just fact check me. Either way, I appreciate every single one of you guys. Take care and stay blessed. Thank you so much for checking out Timeless Black Excellence. Please look at us on Instagram at abdias.lisme42, also at Facebook at Timeless Studios Inc. Please like, share, comment, and subscribe. Thanks, guys.